This is going to be one of the longer videos as we cover the lifeboats. This video is in two parts. Depending on your ship, you would either be having a free fall or a totally enclosed type of lifeboat. Regardless of which type you have, there are certain checks which are common to both types. In the first part, we're going to deal with those checks which are common whether you have a free fall or a totally enclosed lifeboat. And then in the second part, we're going to target each type of lifeboat individually. As you enter the lifeboat, make sure that all safety precautions are taken, including any additional lashings if necessary. You need to ventilate the lifeboat adequately prior entry. When you enter, check for the general cleanliness inside. Access hatches and gaskets should be watertight. As you approach, confirm that the lifeboat markings are proper. Name, port of registry, there's an identification mark like the call sign on top of it. Capacity, lifeboat number, dimensions are clearly marked. The condition of the retro tapes are clean. Try out the lifeboat engines. Your system may be different from this one. Make sure that the battery charger is out before you try it out. Your lifeboat will have two batteries, and it's very important that you try out the engines on both batteries one by one. Also check the heater controls. Engage and try out the engines ahead and astern, and watch the propeller as you do it. Try out the full rudder movement port and starboard. Watch the rudder as you turn the steering. The various instructions and notices must be clearly posted up inside, whether it is to launch the lifeboat or to start the engines. We're going to check the fuel levels now. It says 150 liters on the tank. And as you can see, the fuel is as per the marked level. The dipstick must be clearly marked. Check that the drain plug is in proper condition and the condition of the rubber ball inside should be free of cracks. The searchlight is working fine. The bilge pump is working fine. Diaphragm often gets cracked here. Cabin lights are working properly. Also confirm that the canopy lights outside are working. Magnetic compass inside free of any air bubbles. Seat markings clearly indicated. Check and confirm that the seat belts are in good conditions and they fit properly. Front and rear glasses should be free of cracks. There should not be any sign of damage. Especially in case of freefall lifeboats, these glasses are often seen damaged due to exposure to soot. The tiller should be tried out. Emergency steering should be working. Condition of the hatchets, no sign of damage here. Boat hooks and oars should be in place. The condition of the battery should be checked. It should be charged, ready for emergency. The inventory of the lifeboat must be regularly taken. All essential items marked by IMO symbols. All the lifeboat equipment should be regularly checked and essential items must be within expiry date. Check the condition of the pyrotechnics and the distress signals of the lifeboat, rocket parachute flares, smoke floats, hand flares with their expiry dates in order. Buoyant smoke signals. The first aid kit has an expiry date. Seasickness tablets have an expiry date. Sometimes the radar reflector may also have an expiry date. Drinking water should be in good condition. There should not be any water ingress in the cabinet. The expiry date of any batteries. You must check the condition of the lifeboat ration and its expiry date as well. Fire extinguisher inside should be cleanly maintained, signed regularly with the date. There should be an indication on the hooks to mark that they are secured properly. For this vessel, it is the green mark, the green arrow over here. It might be different on your vessel. For free fall lifeboats, it's extremely important to check that the hooks are secured. As you come out of the boat, take a good look at the outer hull and the fittings outside. There should not be any cracks or damages. Check the condition of the skates, the becketed lines, other external fittings of the lifeboat. And there should be a guard for the propeller. Lifeboat launching instructions must be displayed just below the emergency lights, and these emergency lights should be in working condition. The limit switches on the davits should be free to operate and tried out regularly. You also need to ensure that the muster stations are very clearly marked with an IMO symbol in place. Crew training in the lifeboat is extremely important. Everyone on board must be trained in exactly how to launch the lifeboat, whether you have a totally enclosed type or a freefall type. Well, now that we have seen the kind of checks required for both type of liveboats, let us now take a look at the checks you need to do only if you have a freefall liveboat. As far as the requirements go, once in 3 months, during an abandoned ship drill, the crew should be boarding the lifeboat. They should secure themselves and commence the launch procedures, but they should not be releasing the hook at that point. The boat should then be lowered using the secondary means of launching, which is the davit, and then maneuvered in the water. Once in 6 months, a simulated launching should be carried out as per MSC 1 Circular 1206, and this should include a simulated release of the hook. Once again, the davit must be used to lower the lifeboat in the water. Either way, the boat should be maneuvered in the water after lowering. Very important to check that the lashings are in place and in good condition. The guide rollers on both the sides are free to turn. Make sure that the external checks are done as explained before. The hooks properly secured. The launching arms and appliances in good condition. There should be anti-skid near the launching platform. There should not be any soot accumulation on the lifeboat. And the access to the launching area must be clear and unobstructed. Enter the lifeboat now. Carry out the checks inside as explained before, including the check of the engines and the steering, the glasses not covered or damaged by soot, bilge pump operational, equipment lockers, condition of the seat belts, operating instructions for the lifeboat launching, operating instructions for the steering fixed pin, or any other operating instructions for that matter. There are two launching mechanisms, the main and the emergency. Both of them should be clearly marked with operating instructions in place, and they should be known to all on board.